Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we're devoting full time to floating under the sea. Down the orbit, fish is happy as after the winter. The fish on the land ain't happy. It's hot as day. But fish in the boat is happy. They in the boat is happy. They in the eat us in fricassee. We wanting land folks loves to cook. Under the sea we have to hook. We got no troubles. Life is the bubbles under the sea. Under the sea. Since life is sweet here, we got to be here naturally. Even the sturgeon and the ray, they did the earth and start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it. Under the sea. Play the flute, the cop, play the hop, the place, play the bass and the sound, the chop, the bass, play the brass, the chop, play the tub, the flute is the king of soul.
Yeah,
play the names of the strings, the chop, rocking up the blackfish, he sings his belt and his front, they know where it's at, they know that blowfish blow!
In my hand. And I thought, oh, this is very odd. I wanted to make a wish for Colleen on her birthday because I wanted her to have the most beautiful birthday in the whole world. But it's not even a wishing star, it's just a yellow ball. Maybe if I closed my eyes and I held it in my hands and I moved it around, maybe it would turn into a star. Nah, it'll never happen. I can't turn anything into a star. Only a magical. Oh, it turned into a beautiful star, and I got to make a wish for Colleen on her birthday. And when fairies make wishes, you know they always come true. It's true. So I said, have the wish I wish tonight. I closed my eyes and I made a wish for Colleen, and I know it's going to come true. I wish that she would be surrounded by all her friends. And her big brother Kyle, too, and his friend. And hello, Kyle. And so I decided to make a little song. Would you like to hear me sing a silly song? Would you help me sing it? Can I get everybody to wiggle your fingers? Can I get everybody to make some ears? Make a shell. Make a clock. Okay, follow me and do what I do. Make some wings. Okay. Do what I do. Once I had a little dog, her color it was brown. I taught her how to whistle, make a whistle, to sing and dance and run, make a running voice. Her legs, they were 14 yards long, her ears so very wide. Around the world in half a day, upon her I would ride. Sing fairies all day, sing. A little frog, he wore a vest of red. He leaned upon a silver cane with a top hat on his head. He dreams of far-off places and things to see and do, and all the kings and queens he met while sailing in a shoe. Make a sailboat, everybody. Sing fairies all day. Sing on to May.
Once I had a downy swan. She was so very frail. She sat upon an oyster shell.
We would dance in the middle of the forest. But we don't use our feet when we fly like you people do. We use our hands. Would you like to try it? This is the way we dance when we fly. Can you clap your hands three times? One, two, three. And cross your hands three times. One, two, three. Come on, mommy, you can do this too. And roll your hands like this. And tickle your elbows like Carmen Miranda. Does anybody remember her? Carmen Miranda? And clap, two, three. And cross, two, three. And roll. And tickle your elbows. Very good. And clap, two, three. And cross, two, three. And roll. And tickle your elbows. Put on your imagination caps. Open your eyes real wide. Open your ears real wide. And close your mouth. Okay. Boys, I'm going to come around this way. You're going to miss the story back there. Why don't you come and sit in the back? Sit in the back of the blanket. Come here, my little friend.
He's scared of you.
Oh, he's not scared of me. You're not scared, are you? Does anybody know how a story begins? How does it begin, young lady? Yeah. That's the way this story begins. Once. Come into my story, everybody. Welcome. Once upon a time, in a land far, far away, there lived a beautiful princess. Her name was Princess Colleen. Princess Colleen lived in a splendid castle on the edge of the enchanted forest. One day, Princess Colleen decided to go for a walk in the woods to pick some roses for her mommy, the queen. It was her birthday, and all the great fairies and princesses were going to come to celebrate with her that day. It was going to be the most wonderful day in the world. But this was the night before, so Colleen decided to go for a walk in the woods. Can you make a walk in the woods noise, everybody? Walking in the woods. No, boys. No, no, no. Not back there.
Kyle?
Get the magic.
Come on this way, please, okay?
Get the
you're
magic.
Going to enjoy the show.
Mama, can take out the magic.
She started walking through the woods, and walking through the woods, and walking and walking, walking through the woods. Suddenly she stopped. All of a sudden, she saw the most beautiful rose bush she ever saw. So she decided to pick a rose. Can you pick a rose, everybody? Pick! Can you smell the rose? Ah, the rose smelled so sweet and so fragrant.
Over there.
You've got beautiful roses over there.
But they're not real.
That's all right. She picked this rose, and she took a deep smell of it, and it smelled so sweet and so fragrant, Colleen decided to go to pick another one for the rest of her friends. She was just about to pick another rose when a voice from behind the rose bush said, "How dare you pick that rose?" "Oh my goodness," said the princess. "I'm sorry, I didn't mean to upset anybody." Out from behind the rose bush came a tiny little elf about this big. And he said, "Oh, it's you, Princess Colleen. I'm sorry I yelled at you," he said. "You're the most beautiful princess in all the land. All the fairies and elves in this forest know about you," he said. "You can have all the roses you like." She said, "Thank you, little elf. What's your name?" He said, "My name is Tarquin. I'm the Elfin Knight." She said, "I've never heard of you. Oh, Dad, just a second. Could you come back for a second?" Mr. Raymond, did he run?
Yeah.
He ran just like Kyle did. Okay.
That was Savannah.
Oh,
Emily.
The little elf said, he said, "I wasn't always an Elfin Knight. I used to be a tall and handsome prince like him.
Oh.
And one day, I was riding my horse through these woods." Can you make a horse riding noise, everybody? "I was riding my horse through these woods when all of a sudden a cool breeze started to blow." Can you make a cool breeze, everybody? Whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. And I got very sleepy. Can you get very sleepy? I got very sleepy. Who's snoring? You were snoring. I was snoring. Fairies don't snore. That couldn't have been me. Are you sure that was me? Anyway, everybody go back to sleep. One more second. I hear snoring. Mama snoring. Anyway, the little elf said he fell sound asleep, but he heard this noise. It sounded like this. thought it was a rattlesnake. But it wasn't a rattlesnake. It was worse than a rattlesnake. You know what it was? It was... the wicked elf queen with her magic stick. She shook her stick at the tall and handsome prince and turned him into a tiny elf. But it's a magic stick for the wicked elf queen. She shook it at the tall and handsome prince and turned him into a tiny elf. Now you're my prisoner, and you have to stay in this forest forever, and you can never leave unless a beautiful princess named Colleen comes by to break the spell. Oh my, said Princess Colleen. Is there anything I could do to help you? Well, he said, there is one thing you can do, but it's very dangerous. That's okay, she said. I'm very brave. He said, listen. Tomorrow night is our big fairy festival. It's on the same day as your birthday. You will see me right around midnight tonight. I will be riding a white horse and wearing a crown of gold. You must pull me off the horse and hold on very tight. Can you do that, everybody? Hold on very tight. And no matter what happens, don't let go. Can you say that?
Don't let go.
Say it loud. Don't let go. Yes, said the princess. I can do that. Late that night, she dressed very warmly. She kissed her big brother, Kyle, good night. She kissed her mommy and daddy, good night. She kissed everybody in the castle. And down from the castle gate she went, out into the fairy forest. And she stepped out into the fairy forest. And she looked! And there was the wicked elf queen. She was dressed all in black and purple and very scary looking indeed. And then she saw him, the elfin knight. He was riding, what was he riding?
A white horse.
And what was he wearing on his head?
Crown.
A golden crown. Princess Colleen pulled him off the horse, and she held on very tight, and she remembered the rule. What's the rule? Don't let go. The brave princess held on tight. Ooh, the wicked elf queen saw Colleen, and she grabbed her magic stick. She whispered a terrible spell, and all of a sudden, the little elf in Colleen's arms turned into a gigantic hairy spider. She held onto the hairy spider very tight, and she remembered the rule. What's the rule?
Don't let go.
The brave princess held on tight. Oh, the wicked elf queen got angrier and angrier. She shook her stick again, and all of a sudden, the spider turned into a gigantic rainbow snake. Brave Colleen coiled the snake around her hands and remembered the rule. What's the rule?
Don't let go.
The brave princess held on tight. All of a sudden, the snake disappeared and turned into a gigantic... stick! Did you see that? She held onto the stick very tight and remembered the rule. What's the rule?
Don't let go!
The brave princess held on tight. All of a sudden, the stick disappeared, and standing in its place was a tall and handsome prince like him. Oh my goodness, all the fairies and elves were saved. And the wicked elf queen, why, she spun around and around and disappeared in a puff of smoke. Nobody ever saw her again. All the fairies were freed, and the elves too. They said, 3 cheers for Princess Colleen! Hip hip, hooray! Can you say that, everybody? Hip hip, hooray! Hip hip, hooray! Hip hip, hooray! And the fairy godmother came out of her cottage, and she said, oh, brave princess, your courage and your bravery has saved us all. I dub you the bravest and most beautiful princess in all the land. And I give you this magic wand, but be very careful that you don't turn Kyle into a frog, okay? And she said, I promise. And she gave her her own magic wand to do the rest of the magic with. And the beautiful princess went back to the castle with the handsome prince. You may keep it, my darling, that's for you. And she went back to the castle with the handsome prince. And after all their prenuptial agreements were signed with her accountants and attorneys, they got married. And guess what else happened? They live. How did they live? You know the end of that story. Have you heard that story before?
No.
Wow. Hey, how many people here love to read books? Oh, we fairies, we love to read books. And we go to the library all the time. A wizard in a book. There's no such thing as a wizard inside a book. If a wizard was inside a book, did you see a wizard? No, come on, there's no such thing as a... You saw a wizard come out of this book. Where is he? I don't see him. Abracadabra. Can you say that, everybody? Abracadabra. See? There's no wizard in this book. Oh, here's another magic word. Look. Alakazam. Can you say that? How convenient. See? If there was a wizard, I would see the wizard and I would see the wizard. Here's another magic word, but you gotta be very careful. When not, never to say this magic word. This is the magic word that makes things disappear. So you have to be very careful when you say it. Say it really low, really scary. Can you say it?
Yeah, I took a picture of the tail.
Am I still? Find the fan. Snap. The job's a game. Every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake, a lark, a spree. It's very clear to see. A spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down. The medicine go down. Medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way. Robin feathering his nest has very little time to rest while gathering his bits of twine and twine. No quite intent in his pursuit, he has a merry tune to toot. He knows the song of the people that
in there clapping. Hey, Mary, how are you? Good to get you in the picture.
Good to see you.
Good seeing you. I heard you had some problems.
Yes, I did have a problem.
Well, you look good.
I have a little problem. I got some fluid in my lungs still.
Really?
I have a little, I'm on heavy duty.
That's great.
It takes a lot out of you.
Oh, I'm sure it does. Old age does, too. Yeah, they all do.
They all do, absolutely. I'm kind of partial to snow. I love snow.
I wonder why.
Did you bring all this good weather down with you? It's perfect.
It is wonderful.
And Mom's been freezing for about 2 weeks.
That's it.
Everybody make a nice big circle. No, I can do it.
I just made it do it.
don't know.
I just like the
You've had some pretty lousy weather up there. My brother's house, all his bike friends in North Carolina. He had them all repaired. So he's got this truck. Give her a martini. Straight up. So anyway, now he has to continue to let the water run so it doesn't freeze him yet.
That's what we did one
Christmas day. Yeah. He has a reverse cycle like air, and it's not strong enough to heat that. Well, they don't get the kind of weather. Right? And Deirdre's mother called the other night, said they had a heat wave. It was up to 19. It was down to 2 and 4 for almost 2 weeks. And the bay there is frozen, which is unusual. Cold water takes an awful lot of cold weather. Where'd Colleen go to? What's your name? Pardon me? Nicolette. You had some beautiful job they did on your face. What happened to Colleen? They didn't do anything, huh? Yeah, there she's eating. Hey, smile, Colleen. Happy birthday. She's bashful. How old are you today? 5? Is that yes? I heard that rattle. Okay.
The blackfish is in the scout and the spot. They know where it's at. They know that blowfish blow.
And the flowers grown
in a tiki 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 room.
think or hide away. You hate people, you. If we weren't feeling so starting right away, we'd take the obvious two.
All together in the diggy, 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 diggy room. In the diggy, 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 diggy room.
All the birds sing words and the flowers grow.
In the diggy, 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 diggy room.
Most little birdies will fly away, but the diggy room birds are here to stay.
In the diggy, 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 diggy room. In the diggy, 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 diggy room.
All the birds sing words and the flowers go so.
In the diggy, 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 diggy room.
All the diggy, 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 diggy room. Come here, beautiful fairy grandmother. Are you ready? Here she is. On the count of three. One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Colleen. Happy birthday to you.
Make a wish, everybody. Close your eyes and make a wish while Kelly blows out her candle. Oh, I feel all these wonderful wishes. Oh. Keep on wishing, keep wishing.
Lower.
Good, good, keep wishing. Very good. One more.
When you can open your mouth with a sound, jump right.
Yay! Yay! Woo-hoo! I think all those wishes are gonna come true. Are you? So everybody enjoy.
Who wants a piece of cake? Raise your hand.
We're gonna take care of that for you right now. And anybody who has not had a and anybody else who has not been paying it, young lady, if you want to get your treat, would you
like to get it.
Wonderful feeling, feeling this way.
It's actual.
Oh, don't spill it. Go slow, otherwise you're gonna spill it all.
Why is that bluebird? Everything is satisfied. Zippity-ay. Wonderful feeling. Wonderful.